Hello, hello, beautiful friends. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. It's Meredith from the Cheremere Collective, and I am back with another video. So today we are going to take a look at how I put together my style of flip-flop journals, mostly inspired by Leslie at 507 Willow House Journals. Go check out her channel. She is awesome and such a fun gal to watch craft and listen to. She is a dear. And many other people have inspired me with their version of the flip-flop journal, and I've kind of just morphed mine into the way I like to do them. So I thought to start out our series today, we would do a flip through of this gorgeous journal I've made. I made this about 2 months ago, I think, using papers from Raindrop Lila. And this is her, mainly her Rosie kit, and it is absolutely gorgeous. There are so many beautiful papers in the Rosie kit, so I encourage you to take a look. She gives so many papers in her kit, so it's awesome. You have lots to create with. So anyway, let's get into it. I chose this darling image on the front. I just love it. These two adorable little girls. It's a beautiful focal point, and I love how it makes a nice little pocket right in the front here. And I just did a very simple tag, covered some cardstock in some of the papers, and created this nice little tuck pocket here. So this is my first envelope, and I will show you how to construct the flip-flop journal from start to finish. So just for starters, we're gonna just kind of go through each component, and then I will show you all the bare bones. So this is a small envelope I have on the front, and by putting this on here, it created a nice little pocket here, and you could add a pocket on this part, a tuck spot. You could have your pocket opening on this side. There's so many variations. You could also have this closed up and just have this be another tuck spot there. So that is my first envelope. And as we open up the journal, you can see this is my first signature. And I did not create this with a ton of papers in each signature because I didn't want it to get too chunky because I want to be able to add stuff to it when I actually use the journal and create in it, etc. So anyway, I've used lots of different papers and book pages throughout. This is Ruby and Pearl. This is from, now I'm gonna forget which kit this is from, but I will remember all of them and list them in the description box below. And then I've got lots of vintage book pages in each signature and some ledger, just random items that I have in my stash. This is a book of Shakespeare. And then I create all of my journals with just a simple two-stitch closure with some linen, wax coated linen thread. And then this is just the other part of this back page. And so this is our first signature, simple, simple. The second envelope, which is the largest size, or the main size, is what I attached the first envelope to. And that creates a pocket here. And you could also add a bottom pocket or a top pocket on the face of this as well. My next signature is connected right here, so in between the next two envelopes. And this is some beautiful Edith Holden book page, and just more of my stash. This is a Ruby and Pearl from her basic documents kit. I think this is Roxy Creations by Rachel. Some nature pages and some of my vintage music books from long ago when I used to play. Yes, they're vintage now. And the back of that gorgeous Edith Holden. So now we're going to flip out. Hello, sorry. Not sure what happened there. And you can see now this is the main component. So there are six flip outs. So we have one, and we have two, three, four, five, and the back of that envelope, it makes six. So you can do whatever you want in these sections. Some people put their second signature here. I actually like it here because I think it folds better and you can stuff it a little bit more. So I like to use these middle pages for either like flip outs or adding nice long tags or envelopes. Pretty much the sky's the limit. You can put whatever you want in there and deco it however you like. And then we get to the last flap, and then this is our fourth signature. And just like the others, we've got some book pages. This is Ruby and Pearl, as is this, front and back, some more of my French book pages. It's just some newsprint, another Edith Holden for the center, and so on. So then we get to the very back page, and you, of course, could easily put pockets on this side. So we're gonna fold back up and get to the flippy part. So now we are ready to go to the back. So this is the back of that first large envelope, and this will be the third one. So then this is our fourth signature. Some more Edith Holden. This is Ruby and Pearl. I think this is her antique garden kit. Some Roxy Creations by Rachel. This is her old book pages kit, both front and back. And then some, just some copy dyed paper. And as we open up the back portion, it's very similar to the inside, where you have these nice three panels here where you can add lots of goodies. You could actually add another signature here or here, but you know, it's just gonna bulk it up a little bit more. If your papers tend to curl up a little bit, you can just do a little hot glue, or you could add washi strips down. I don't really worry about that too much because this is my personal journal and I know it's going to be well loved and used, and so if I need to make repairs as I go, I can easily do that. So that is the totality of the components, all put together and decorated. And so now I will show you how to actually create the envelope flip-flop style the way I like to do it, and we will go forward from there. Okay, so here we have our completed journal, and now I will show you how I like to put them together. So you're going to need four envelopes. I like to use three tall ones, all the same size, and then you can choose whatever size you want of the smaller envelope. Sometimes what I do is I grab an envelope that's maybe not quite the same size, and I just trim it down to whatever size I like. So for this one, this was actually a pretty small envelope to begin with, and I just cut the side down because it was a little too wide. And that is actually what I'm gonna do with this one, because as you can see, excuse me, it is wider than the regular envelope. So I am just gonna grab my paper trimmer real quick before we get going. And I'm just gonna cut off about an inch or so. So now we have a smaller size. And that way you can choose to have your pocket be like so, or maybe open it up and have it be a top tuck. So the first thing you're going to do is grab a glue stick that isn't empty. And what I like to do with my large envelope is tuck in the flap like so. And you can glue it down if you want, but it's not going to go anywhere. So I'm going to show you how I like to reinforce this part with some cardstock so that it's a little sturdier when we get going. So this part of the envelope, you are going to put glue on the flap. And you're gonna lay that down however you like it. I tend to have mine be not fully centered, and I like to have it, be just a little bit up from the bottom, but farther from the top, if that makes sense. And so here at the moment, we have an opening on this side and an opening on this side. So we'll decide if we're gonna seal this part up and have the pocket be here, or if we're gonna open it up here and seal this, we can do that down the road. Don't have to decide that right now. So here we have our first flip out. Okay, and I'm just showing you the very basic way that I do this. I have created other flip-flop journals where I have this flip out, and then I add another envelope here that flips out here as well. So it's kind of like a double layer, but we're not gonna do that today. Alrighty, so the next thing we are going to do is take our remaining two envelopes, and we are going to trim off just a very tiny bit from each end. And you can do it with scissors or paper trimmer, whatever you've got on hand that makes it easy. You can use an X-Acto knife, that works well also. And you don't want to take off too much, because otherwise you're going to end up with envelopes that are a little bit smaller than the main one, and we don't want that. So now we have this open and this open, and I am going to just be a little bit fussy and trim off these little tabs here, because I don't need those or want those on my envelope. And you can even flip these little bits off here too. And this is just me being a little bit picky, but it saves me from having to continuously be gluing stuff down. Alrighty, so now we have all our envelopes open, and we're gonna take this first one and apply glue to the flap again. And you kinda wanna be fairly generous with your glue. And then you are going to take that flap and tuck it inside, being careful not to go over the crease, because you want this part to still be able to fold. And if you want to flip it over, you can push it down a little bit more. It should be pretty secure. And then we are going to take our third and final envelope and do the same thing. So glue on the flap. And you can do this on the top or the bottom of the envelope, it's up to you. I just tend to work what makes sense to me, and this is what makes sense to me. So there again, we're gonna place that down, even it up, and make sure that you have a spot for your envelope to still bend. And it looks like I actually got that a little bit too far away, so we're gonna try again here and get it lined up a little bit better. So when this happens, I flip it over and do it like that. So if it happens to you, you can do the same thing. So now we still have our fold and we're good. So now we have our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 panels, and we're gonna go ahead and fold. So, as you can see here, this flap is coming over this line, so we're going to want to fold it down a bit so that you have some room between your folds. And it's okay if you know, you can even cut it off if you want. Either way works as well, but I just like to go ahead and fold it. It's all going to be covered up anyway, so it doesn't matter. And there we have our first flip-flop envelope. So when we open it up, we're going to have this flip out here. There's going to be a signature here, and we have our pocket have a pocket here, or top tuck, whatever we're gonna do. And then we're gonna have signature number two here. And when we open up and up, we have these panels that are open with nothing on them. They're just gonna be papers, and we might do pockets and things later, but this is where the fourth signature goes. So then we fold it in, and then back on itself. So then when we flip it over this way, this is our panel for the fourth signature. And then you open up and up, and one more time out, and then these panels will be left blank, or however you would like to decorate them. Always optional to add more to them as you go, but not necessary. Sorry, I totally folded that wrong, so let's try again. There we go. So anyway, I hope that was pretty well explained. Please let me know if you have any questions. And this will be part one of our video. I will show you one that I have already kind of completed and prepped for the paper. Once I make the base, I like to take my Tim Holtz inks and I ink all of the edges, and I reinforce my pockets with some cardstock. So we will start with that in the next video and start picking out our papers that we're gonna add. So if you want to catch up to this point and be ready for the next step, I would love for you to join me. Thanks so much for being here today, and I hope you have a wonderful day. See you soon.